today we're going to talk about this one particular excerpt from the Symphonic Dances from West Side Story. Now, this is the band version of the Symphonic Dances, arranged by somebody named Lavender. Mr. Lavender made this arrangement. I've played it. And this recording that we just heard is of the Marine Band. Okay, so why are we listening to this excerpt? Why are we listening to the Marine Band play this excerpt? Well, all of the service bands have this excerpt, and only this excerpt from West Side Story, on their audition list for bass clarinet. There is so much cool stuff for bass clarinet that they could have put on it. Why would they pick this particular excerpt? Well, I have a theory, and I'm going to talk about that theory and how I think you should prepare this excerpt for an audition right now. All right, so let me throw the music up here on the screen and let's take a look at it. As you can see, this is from the U.S. Navy Band audition packet from the bass clarinet audition from April 2023. And this excerpt here is written allegretto, swing, and let's take a quick look at how it's written. It's not written like it sounds. It's written with straight eighth notes with staccatos underneath them. If I were to play what's written here, it would sound like this. And the audition committee would usher me out of the room. Thank you very much, Mr. Lowenstern, but no thanks. This is why this is on the audition. On a normal orchestral audition, in fact, on other pieces on this audition, you are expected to play exactly what is written on the page. Every articulation, every note, everything, all of the expressive stuff within a very narrow set of parameters are basically dictated to you by convention. Here, it's not. You are called upon to interpret what is written here in a way like you've never done on any of these other, no Beethoven sixth interpretation. No, the clarinet part is the clarinet part, and it's been the clarinet part since Beethoven wrote it, and everybody plays it the same way, and you are expected to too. There is a different way to approach this. So let's take it apart and take a close look at it. First of all, that first theme there does not sound like it looks. That motive is not. So our job is to get you from to. You are excused from not knowing this. If you came up through, let's call it a classical, traditional, conservatory or college training, you are a classical musician and you are used to playing, you don't have a lot of jazz band experience. If you have jazz experience, you're probably not watching this video because you already know this stuff. But if you don't, what you need to understand is that jazz and jazzy are not the same thing. If I were to play this jazzy, I would think, oh, well, okay, it's written like straight eighth notes, but in fact, I should really just play a dotted eighth sixteenth, which would sound like this. Which sounds okay, but it sounds dorky as hell in the very beginning, because it's nothing that you would ever hear a jazz band or big band play, ever. First thing we need to do is, let's just move the rhythmic stuff off to the side for a second. Let's talk about articulation first. Notice, it's not the same as, but wait, it's written with three staccato notes. I didn't play three staccato notes. That's correct. This is the essence of what you need to learn how to do. And I have a trick for you to learn how to do this, especially with this particular excerpt. Let's think of it like a word, okay? There are some words that we say where emphasis is on a certain syllable and that syllable is either drawn out or clipped, you know, less emphasized, et cetera, et cetera. So I have the perfect word for this, and the word is potato. If you think about the word potato, now you don't say potato. No, that's not how you say that word. At least I hope that's not how you say that word. What we're thinking here is that last toe, the potato, is not emphasized. It's sort of swallowed. Potato. And the second syllable, te, is actually potato. It's got a little emphasis. Pa, the first one, is short, pa, but it really leads into the second one. Potato, potato. So say that a few times. Potato, potato. And then try and play it. Play it exactly how you say it. If you play potato, you will be playing it basically correctly. It has the swing built into it, and it has the emphasis built into it, and it has the articulation built into it. So it is the perfect. Have you ever known potato to not be the perfect vegetable anyway? Who doesn't love French fries? And just practice. practice that over and over again. Record it, see if it sounds dorky. If it sounds dorky, say the word potato a few more times. You will get it. Let's look ahead here to measure 585, where the stringendo starts. And the last beat of this measure, that we're done with potatoes, basically. At least potatoes by themselves. It sounds like this. All right, so the first three notes, let's slow it down a lot. Sounds familiar, right? But the last two, we're not talking potatoes anymore. How about potatoes and peas? All right, potatoes and peas, potatoes and peas. You'll notice potatoes and peas. There's a little bit of that crescendo and peas. So that's what you want to do. You really want to go to that last F, and then the next three notes really are just accents. And then, almost like you're playing Daphnis. In summary, potato is your friend. Potato is the way to play this excerpt. Do not place what's written here. Play an interpretation of that. We have interpreted today as potatoes. You may find a different word that you prefer to potatoes, but I gotta tell you honestly, I can't think of one. I'm not teaching you how to play jazz here. I'm just teaching you how to play this excerpt. Jazz is a much, much bigger topic, and we just need to get you through this particular audition. So jazzy, dotted A16ths and triplets and stuff like that are not gonna cut it. Get used to potatoes, because in the Army, you're probably gonna be eating a lot of potatoes. If you have any questions about this or any excerpts like this, put them in the comments. We're gonna talk a little bit more about it, because there's another excerpt right below this that's jazz, but we will do that next time. Stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching. Bye.